Hello and welcome back to another video here at Pragmatic Works. Today we're going to talk about the most exciting, the number one question asked here at Pragmatic Works across any class, across any presentation. What tool are you using to draw on the screen? What tool are you using to put a break timer up on the screen? This is an awesome tool and it's called Zoomit. Now I'm going to tell you three things about Zoomit real quick. One, Zoomit is free. That's the first thing you need to know and it's important. Two, I have been working with Zoomit for over 11 years. I've been presenting with it for over 11 years in this tech field, in person, on site, and also virtual, and it is awesome in all three scenarios. Number three, it's easy to use. It's scary how easy it is to use this tool. So I'm gonna go through a quick video just walking you through this tool, Zoomit, and the capabilities and exactly how you can take advantage of it. First, let's go straight to the Microsoft documentation and take a look at where you can download this tool so you can follow along. If you go right here to learn.microsoft.com, you can download this. Now make sure to take a look in the description after this video so that you can get the link there as well. And if you go down just a little bit, you can download it right here, but if you zoom down, there's a little video here that's hard to see that it's actually a video. There's an introduction, and then there's a whole bunch of tips and tricks on how you can actually use this tool. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up Zoomit on my machine and I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of show you this real quick. You'll notice that if I just want to zoom in, I can use Control plus one. Control one is the tool that I've used for 11 years to zoom in when I have Zoomit active and open on my machine. The other thing I can do on my machine is I can draw. Drawing is very illustrative. It is very much important when I want to kind of highlight something on the screen or I want to draw my attendants, the students of a class, I want to draw them to that section of the screen. Being able to draw quickly, efficiently without just moving my mouse around wildly is very, very nice. In fact, when I see people doing some of those other things, it makes me want to do this video to say, hey, there is a better way to do it. So that's going to be the draw tool. For control three, you might wonder, what is three? Three is going to be the break tool. This is a break timer that you can put up on your screen. This has a lot of capability within this advanced option right here where you can add additional pictures, etc. We'll come back to that in just a moment. And finally, the last thing that I use very extensively is something called Live Zoom. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. And then we're just gonna kind of work through a couple of these options real quick so you can get familiar with it, and then I'll let you just play around with this as much as you want on your own. First of all, Live Zoom. If I zoom in, this will let me zoom in so that you can see the screen a little bit better. Now, it defaulted to 200%, but if I scroll in with my mouse wheel, I can go even further. I can go way into that screen, right? I can also click somewhere on the screen, like click here, and when I click, it immediately takes me into draw mode, meaning I'll be able to draw on the screen. And you'll notice that my cursor is now red and it gives me that option. If I get to where I have frozen the screen and I put a rectangle around something and I do this and I get to the point where I want to move further, well, the screen's frozen. Notice it's not letting me move. But if I right click on my mouse, so this is a tip for you. If I right click on my mouse, it takes me out of that frozen mode and I can kind of zoom in and zoom out and move around. Really cool. If I hit Control 1, it'll take me out of that screen. That is the zoom and freeze feature capability here. Now, the other thing that I can do here is I can use Control 2. And what Control 2 does is it allows me to draw on the screen, right? So when I hit Control 2, I get that little cursor back. My mouse turns into the little crosshair and you see the color red. And what I can do from here is I can draw boxes on the screen, I can draw lines on the screen, I can draw arrows on the screen, I can draw text on the screen, I can do a lot of different things. So let me walk you through a couple of those capabilities just real quick. One, if I hold down the control button, I can click on my mouse button and I can draw rectangles around different things on the screen. If I hold down control plus shift at the same time, that will help me to draw an arrow on my screen, control plus shift. If I want to change the color of my arrows, I can hold down Control blue for B, so Control B, or I can do Control G for green. I can do Control Y for yellow, right? So there's quite a few different colors and I can change the color palette of my cursor if I want as I'm working in this mode. Another thing I can do, as I highlighted earlier, is I can type text on the screen. So I can say, you know, one, go to learn.microsoft, right? And download this tool. And then I can go down to the next line and I can do two, and I can continue to type on the screen. So this is another feature capability. The final part about drawing that I want to highlight is if I hit Control W here, if I escape out of there, and let me just kind of get out of this screen. If I hit Control 2 and then I just hit Control W, this gives me a whiteboard to work with. And I find this to be very helpful, very intuitive when I'm doing different things and I'm trying to be illustrative about different concepts, like a star schema, and I need to draw on the screen and draw my arrows, I can really take advantage of this whiteboarding tool. So this is really awesome. We've talked about the kind of zoom in and freeze feature capability you get with Control 1. We've talked about Control 2, which is being able to freeze the screen, but also be able to draw on the screen, which is great. Control 3 is a crowd favorite as well, and that is a break timer. Or if you're getting ready to start an event, you can throw this timer on the screen and you can just say, hey, we're gonna get started in about 9 minutes. See everybody back here in just a few minutes. This is way better than telling everybody, hey, we need you to come back at 3:17 p.m. You can just throw this timer on the screen. You'll also notice that there is a background image that has appeared. That's because if you go into the Zoomit tool by hitting Windows and typing in Zoomit and opening it up, you can click on Advanced and you can put any background image in there you want. So I've seen, you know, a lot of our different trainers here at Pragmatic Works be really creative with those different options that exist. But this is just a screen and a timer that we have. If I hit the up arrow on my keyboard, I can add minutes or I can reduce minutes. If I hit the left arrow, I can go down in 10-second intervals. Or if I hit the right arrow, I can go up in 10-second intervals. Okay, this has been great. We're almost near the end. The last thing I want to show you, this is my favorite capability, and this is going to be the live Zoom option. We teach a lot of classes here. We do a lot of training. We do a lot of virtual mentoring. And when we're showing code, when we're writing Python or Java or SQL or DAX or MDX or PySpark, whatever it is, right? If we're writing code, we're teaching it, we're helping, it is important that you can see our screen. And so if I hit Control 4, what Control 4 does is it's very similar to Control 1 that it zooms in, but then it will allow me to actually type and interact with the screen while I'm zoomed in. So this is called Live Zoom. So I can come in here, I can type, I can explain about the IntelliSense, the pop-up, the autocomplete capability, and I can walk students through the screen. This is an incredible feature, and I honestly don't think I could be a trainer or a presenter without a feature with this type of capability. It just makes the life for me as an instructor so much better, but also for anybody who is attending any presentations that I do. And when I attend others' presentations and they're using this tool, I am so very, very thankful. This was a quick video. There's a lot to cover with Zoomit. It's such a powerful tool, but I wanted to go through as much as I could, as fast as I could. We hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. And if you like this type of video, not necessarily the technical how-to videos that we've done in the past on other tools that we use, but a video on how we use different tools to present and do things like that, let us know in the comments below and we'll make sure to do more videos for you. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.